Hello students, welcome you all in my YouTube channel Dr. Saroj Chimpa Agri Classes. Hope you are doing well. In last video we have studied about introduction to horticulture. Today we will study about pomology. In this topic we study different points like what is pomology, what is fruit, fruit structure and edible parts of a fruit. So let's start topic pomology. What is pomology? Pomology is a branch of horticulture which deals with the cultivation and management of fruit crops. The word pomology has driven from two Latin and Greek words. The word pomum has driven from Latin word which means fruit. Whereas the word logy has driven from Greek word which means study or science. So we can say pomology is the science of fruit growing. According to this definition, we can say that pomology is the science or study of fruit growing. Now question arises, what is the need to study about pomology? Or what are the major objective to study about pomology? So let's see. The major aim to study about pomology is to improve fruit crops and enhance fruit quality. So we have understood it very well that in pomology we study about fruit production, then its major objective is to enhance fruit quality or enhance fruit crop production. Now let's see its branches of pomology. Pomology has been divided in three different branches. The number one is basic pomology or fundamental pomology. In fundamental pomology, we study about fundamental aspects related to fruit crop production like training and pruning of fruit crops, water management, seed bed preparation, etc. The number two branch is systematic pomology. In systematic pomology, we study about nomenclature and classification of fruit crops. And the third one is commercial pomology. In commercial pomology, we study about commercial aspect of fruit production. As we know, pomology is the study of fruit growing. So we should know what is fruit. So let's see the definition of fruit. Fruit is a fleshy or dry ripened ovary and its associated parts in angiosperms. According to this definition, we understood very well that fruit is a ripened ovary. It consists seed in it, and the purpose of the fruit is the protection and dissemination of the seed. Students, have you ever listened about true fruits or false fruits? Yes, you have listened. On the basis of flower parts used, fruits are of two types. The number one is true fruit and number two is false fruit. True fruit is also known as eucarp. Eucarp developed from ripened ovary after fertilization. Example, mango or banana. Or we can say true fruit is a simple fruit. It developed from ripened ovary. The second one is false fruit. False fruit is known as pseudocarp, spurious and accessory fruit. It develops from flower parts like thalamus, inflorescence other than ovary. Its example are apple and strawberry. So we can say false fruit developed from other parts of the flower like thalamus or inflorescence. It doesn't include ovary. The next part is structure of a fruit. As we know, a typical fruit has got two parts in it. The number one is seed and number two is pericarp. Pericarp is the outer covering of a fruit. It has been divided in three parts. The number one is exocarp. Exocarp is the outermost part. It forms skin in the fruit. The second one is mesocarp. Mesocarp is the middle portion of the fruit and it forms flesh in the fruit. And the third one is endocarp. Endocarp forms pith in the fruit. In this structure, we have seen different parts of a fruit. As I told you that these different layers are parts of pericarp. According to this part, fruit have different edible part. Let's see this edible part in this slide. The number one is, the number one edible part is pericarp. Pericarp is consumed in bear and date palm. The number two is mesocarp. Mesocarp means flesh portion of this structure, flesh portion of this fruit part. The mesocarp is considered as edible portion in papaya, mango and spota. And you know very well, in papaya, spota and mango, we consume this middle portion, except this pericarp. The next one is endosperm. Endosperm is the edible portion in coconut. And coconut, in coconut, endosperm is a liquid portion which get converted in solid form. The next one is mesocarp and endocarp. Mesocarp and endocarp are the edible portion in avla and banana. The next one is mesocarp and epicarp. In peach, plum, falsa, jamun and karonda, mesocarp and epicarp are the edible portion. Here we can see this thing in our structure, fruit structure, that mesocarp and epicarp. This mesocarp and outer covering epicarp is to be consumed. The next one is juicy placental hair. You have seen that in citrus fruit, there are a lot of juicy placental hair that are used to be edible part. The next one is fleshy thalamus. Fleshy thalamus is consumed in all sort of false fruits like apple, pear and strawberry. The next one is fleshy receptacle. Fleshy receptacle is consumed in fig. In cashew apple, we consumed fleshy peduncle. Here, no need to be confused in cashew apple and cashew nut. Cashew apple is a succulent fruit. It is a part of cashew nut. The next one is fleshy aril. Fleshy aril is the edible portion in lychee. And next is cotyledon. Cotyledon is an edible part in all sort of dry nuts like cashew nut, almond and pistachio nut. The next one is juicy seed coat. In pomegranate, you can easily identify these juicy seed coats. In pomegranate, juicy seed coats is to be taken. The next one is succulent placenta. Succulent placenta is the major edible part in wood apple and bean. The next one is pericarp and placenta. In grapes, pericarp and placenta is major portion to be eaten. And next is thalamus and pericarp. Thalamus and pericarp is the edible portion in guava. And the last one is bract and perianth. Bract and perianth are the major edible portion in jackfruit and pineapple. These all about fruits. In next video, we will study about classification of fruits.